Hello everyone. So in this video we are going to learn how to record our very first macro. Now what are macros? Macros are the first step towards the VBA. It's like automating your entire task. Suppose I'll give you a very small example. When you click on Control S, it saves your file. Exactly if I say in the similar manner, you use certain shortcuts and you can perform certain tasks which you want to, which is not default or inbuilt in the Excel, and you can create that task using the macros, using the record macro feature, and you can use it again and again in future. Basically, you are automating your task which you have to perform maybe yearly, maybe monthly, maybe quarterly, so that you do not have to manually perform the task again and again by just hitting a button or by just using a shortcut, you can execute that particular task. Moving on, I'll keep this class very, very basic. So first of all, I need a developer tab over here. To get the developer tab, we go to the file section, and over here we have options. In options, we have customize ribbon, and I'll click on the developer tab. I'll tick the checkbox and I'll click on OK so that I get the developer tab. In the developer tab, there is a feature called record macro. You can use this feature, or you have this record macro option at the very bottom. So you can click on any of these. Let me just click on this particular button over here. The moment I click on this button, I get a record macro dialog box. Now, what is the name which you want to give to your macros? Suppose I'll give the name as my first macro. Also remember that first macro, your names cannot have spaces. There is a naming convention as to how you can name the macros. That is there in my separate class. Now you need to give a shortcut, so it depends on you. It is not a compulsory field. You can give any shortcut or you can just skip this particular field. Let me just give a quick shortcut. Generally we give shortcuts which are not taken or default shortcuts of Excel. So let me give a shortcut as Control Shift F. So I'll press Shift and F and I'll get Control Shift F. I pressed Shift and F, so I got Control Shift F, right? Then where do you want to store your macro? I will just keep it as this workbook. We have many different ways to store the workbook in. Okay, just if you want to give a description, I will just say formatting first row. Again, these fields are not mandatory. Whatever default options are there, like macro name was macro 1, so you can keep that. If you want to edit, you can edit the fields as well. I'll just click on OK. The moment I click on OK, you can observe this button which we have, this and the record macro changes to stop recording. See, it changes to stop recording, and over here it changes to a stop recording button over here. Now I will record my first macro. My aim is to just modify my first row. So I'll select the entire first row. After selecting the entire first row, I'm going to my home tab. Let me just give it a nice color. So I'll just give it a nice color. Let me just increase the size to 13 and keep it as bold. So this is how I have edited my first row. And then what you can do, you can just click anywhere in your, suppose I'm clicking on cell A1, okay? So you can do that or you can leave it. My aim was to just modify my first row. Two things which I did was I changed the size, I changed it into a bold, and also I changed the color. If also you want to give a border, you can again select the entire thing, and let me just give a down border over here, bottom border. So that is done. Four things I have done. I have changed it into bold. I have increased the size, font size. I have given it a new color, a good color. And also I have added a border, a bottom border. This is my macro, and I will just click on the stop button. And now it has stopped recording, as you can see. And the entire procedure, entire four steps has been recorded in your macro. You can execute the same in your different sheets. Let me just check. I'm going to my sheet 1 over here. You do not have to do anything else. You just need to use the shortcuts which you have used when you were recording the macro, and the shortcut was Control Shift and F. So I'll just click on Control Shift and F. I just clicked on Control Shift and F, and see, I got the entire row formatted. The second way of just getting your macro again or running your macro again, the first way was to use the shortcut, which we did using the Control Shift and F. Other way is you can simply go to your macro option over here, select the macro which you want to run. So let me just keep it as this workbook, and I'll select my first macro. This was the name which I gave to my macro, and I can just hit run over here. The moment I hit run, you can see everything has been executed. Let me just type and see. Demo 1, it has been bold, and now the size, let me just check the size of this. The size is 40. So this is how you can record your macro. This was a very basic macro which I have recorded, and I have told you the two ways of how to execute the macro. The first one was to use the shortcut key. Let me show this again. So I'll just click on Control Shift and F. Control Shift and F, and see, I get the entire thing again. Or you can go to your macros, select from the list if you have more than one macro, and just click on the run. These are the two basic ways. There are n number of ways. To be precise, there are 8 to 10 ways as to how you can run your macro, right? So these were the two very basic ways. Thank you so much.